everyone. Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm excited to show you my newest fabric design called Stitch. Now, this is the Riley Blake storyboard, which is how we show our fabric. And it just comes with several pages and shows all of the things coming. And normally we would be in Houston, Texas, and showing this, but because of everything that's been going on in the world, we are doing a virtual quilt market. So I'm going to just take you through the storyboard and talk to you about Stitch and all of the things involved with it. So you can see on the cover that here's the quilt for the So Simple Shape Sew Along, and we'll be talking about that later. First, I want to just show you the fabrics. So there's 42 fabrics in this collection. And I've used each one of these prints within the quilt. And on a storyboard, I like that you can see the skews and the name of the fabric and just a little piece of each so that you can see what they look like together. But I did do a print off of these so that you can see in a bigger piece of paper in actual scale, so you can kind of see what each print is going to look like. So I'm just going to go through these. These are all just sewing words and having to do with Stitch. Now, as I'm showing you these, I'm going to talk about why I call this collection Stitch. It's in honor of all things Stitch, meaning sewing, stitching, hand stitching, crochet stitch, cross stitch, knitting, applique. This print right here, in fact, is called applique. This is the print that's on the border of the quilt. And I did it in a beautiful nutmeg background because it looks very vintage that way. I'm always inspired by the colors of my grandmother's house and her sisters, my great aunts. So I grew up in a very small rural community, and I was lucky enough to live next door to my grandma and my aunts and uncles and cousins. And so growing up, I was in many older homes and saw how cute and quaint they were decorated. And so I just really, you know, that's where my love of vintage comes from. I've always loved those colors, and I wanted to do everything kind of that encompassed Stitch. These two prints are really fun. I'll show you in the quilt what we're going to do with these, but these are a fun, this is a fun background, and this is a darker background, but you can see there's X's on here. But I kind of did this print in, you know, like in honor of the printed cross stitch, meaning there's already X's on here, and you could just take any cross stitch pattern and actually stitch it on here to put in a quilt, and that's exactly what we're going to do for one of the blocks in the quilt. And then these four prints here, they're called Ditzy, and I did this, I love this print so much, I did it in four colors. And I love it because it has all of the colors in the collection in here. And so it makes it really a versatile print. I also did this in four colorways. This is called the Stitched Flower, making it very versatile as well. And then I did this one in four ways. This print is called Hexie. I did this in four colorways. And then I did these two that are kind of a little houndstooth with a daisy that kind of looks like gingham. And they go really nice with the dark raisin steel color and the cayenne red. These two prints are called Wildflower. And then these, of course, are the Vintage Ladies. Now I did this print in my decorator weight fabric, my happy place. And so I reduced the scale of it a little bit for cotton fabric. And then it's also got a cloud ground to it. And these are really fun. Always love to do these vintage ladies because they represent my grandma and her old sewing patterns and her sisters, my great aunts. Now this print is called Crochet. And you can see it's like the little crochet patterns. And this is a granny circle and granny squares. And this is a really fun background, low volume background. And then I did it in this cottage as well. So those are the 42 prints that go in the quilt. But of course we can, you know, use them for so many other things. But let's continue in here. I always like to do a specialty print, what I call a specialty print, meaning it's kind of a larger print. It's not a wide back. It's regular, you know, 44 or 45 wide fabric that comes on the bolt, but just something that goes with the collection and can be used for like pillowcases or curtains or aprons or the backs of smaller quilts or table runners or pillows. And so what this one is a cross stitch. And so this is the actual scale. I'm gonna bring it a little closer. That's the actual scale. But it has a lot more designs than you can see on the storyboard. So I printed this off to show you all of the designs that are in that cross stitch. It's really gonna be fun. I can think a lot for, you know, a lot of uses for that. And then go ahead and turn the page. And I also have a cheater cloth with this, which I call a cheater because my grandma used to call them cheaters. And what it is I drew up the quilt blocks, and this is the actual scale in here. But you can see from these two prints, I kind of printed them smaller just so you could see all of the blocks in that print. But here's the actual scale of those blocks. So I just printed them on 11 by 17 paper so you could kind of see some of the blocks that size. So I'm really excited about that. For those cheater prints, I've been making like a quilt for my bed and tying it in the corners, or you could quilt them. They're really fun. And then these are the three wide backs that come with stitch right here. So I took the applique print from the collection and I enlarged it. I think this will be really fun on the back of quilts and also for fussy cutting. My wide backs are very good quality and you can use them in the front of the quilts as well for borders and or anything, but wouldn't these be fun for fussy cutting and even like hexies for English paper piecing or something like that. So looking forward to using those. And so the next thing in the storyboard is the quilt. So I'll talk to you about that a little bit. So here's the quilt. It's called My Happy Place. It's 76 by 88. And this is kind of half applique and half pieced. So all of these little blocks in here you can see are applique kind of surrounding here. This is a big applique block. These are applique. They're just fabric swatches. This is the crochet section. This is kind of the cross stitch and embroidery section, the ironing, you know, all the tomato pin cushions. But you can see that the sewing machine is quite large. So I don't have so simple shapes. For that, we piece it. So it's a quite large sewing machine. And then everything else is applique, has the so simple shapes. So this is pieced. This is pieced. And then I have 10 quilt blocks in here that are all pieced as well. And I did do a print off of those quilt blocks, a few of them, so you could see. So this is actual scale and the actual fabrics that we'll be using. Block six is within the quilt right here on the design board. I don't happen to have that one copied, but it's right there. That one. Some of these go in the corners and then some of them go within the quilt. But they're going to be really fun to piece. So there are several piece blocks and several applique. And on the storyboard, it always tells you the fabric requirements and then the notion requirements. The quilt, like I said, is called My Happy Place, and the sew along starts in, let's see, on August 23rd. My sew alongs are always on a Monday, and I just like to keep it that way as far as the Sew Simple Shapes sew alongs. I always have two sew alongs with Sew Simple Shapes every year. One is in January and one is in August. So this one will be in August because the fabric comes in July. So here are the Sew Simple Shapes. They are called My Happy Place. I have new design boards and new size rulers coming. I have a puzzle. I have a binder so that we can use that binder now for the sew along guide. I have a keychain and I have a mug, a tomato pincushion mug. And it's the same kind of mugs as my enamel mugs that I've had for past collections. It's going to look the same size, just new design. And it will have the tomato pin cushions going all the way around. This is the front and this is the back. I do have some buttons coming out because we'll be using that for the quilt. You see that button jar right there? We're going to applique the button jar, but then actually put buttons in there. Now I have a lot of cute little buttons. We're going to use the smaller package for that, one small package, but I wanted to design some bigger buttons so that we could use for bigger things, for bags or clothing or whatever. And sorry about that noise if you don't like it, but I love the sound of playing with buttons. My grandma used to let me play with her button jar. So I just kind of wanted to give you a peek of these buttons and what they're going to look like. The largest one is 1 inch, and then they go on down to 1/2 inch. And so these are called the stitch buttons. And let's see, I've got washi tape coming out as well. I use washi tape for many things. I use washi tape for my Seam So Easy guide to put on my machine. I use it for my light box when I'm taping patterns to my light box to trace off, and you know, just for different patterns and different things. You may be surprised if you've never used washi tape how many uses there is for that. And I love it because it's like, think of it as like miniature painting tape. You know how the painter's tape doesn't leave a residue and you can peel it off. That's why I love the washi tape. So you can use it with paper and fabric. And I have two little school charms coming. And then, oh, I wanted to show you this right here. I didn't talk about the stitch grid notebook paper. So I took that cheater cloth print that I showed you earlier and I put it on this new notebook that's coming. This is the actual size right here. This is the back of it. And it's going to be, you know, have the spirals, and it's going to have a little grid paper on it that's light pink grid, and so you can use it to write on or to draw your quilt blocks. So this is the actual size. This is the back. This is what the front looks like. It's just that cheater cloth print, and then the back, and it's going to be full of the graph paper. And I'm looking forward to that because graph paper is so useful in so many different things for quilting and cross stitch, and so that will be a very useful notebook. And lastly, let's talk about these quilts that I do that come in this cute box. This one is the tomato pin cushion quilt, and it comes in the larger box, and we use 10-inch squares, 10-inch stackers for that. And then this one is a table runner. This is the spools and bobbin runner. And it uses 5-inch squares and 5-inch stackers. And that will come in the decorative box as well. So that is all about stitch. It will be here July 2021. and I'm super excited about it. And thanks for letting me chat about it a little bit and show you my excitement. So next I'm going to talk to you about flea market, which I'll be getting here in about a month. I've been getting a few pieces from their pre-yardage, and so I'm going to talk to you about that in a minute. So let me go grab it. Okay, so now I'm back again with flea market, and I've got the flea market storyboard here. This is the sew along quilt flea market flowers that we'll be doing, but I want to show you fabric first. So here are the fabric prints in flea market. And on these first three pages, you can see 42 prints. And so I'm just now starting to get my pre-yardage in because this fabric will be here next month, which is December 2020. And so I have some of the actual fabrics that I can show you that I've received. And then I've printed off the ones that I haven't received so I can show you. But first I want to talk about the background. I'm really super excited about this because it's one of my favorite pieces. It was so fun to design. It took a long time, but I think it really turned out great and it's really worth it. I took vintage ledgers and price tags and receipt books and things like that and laid them out, and they were all blank. And then I went ahead and filled them in. And it has a lot of different meaning as far as family. Like, so this one right here is a receipt book from a store called Grace Goods. My daughter's name is Cassidy Grace, and so that's, you know, named after her. And I have a son, Sterling, so I named this one Sterling Finds, and then I listed things maybe that you would find in a flea market, you know, from a shop called Sterling Finds. I have, here's being my bonnet company. My oldest son is called Benjamin. And let's see, where is that one? It's here somewhere, but there's a shop named after Benjamin. There's Busy Bee Farms. I have the town that I grew up in, a town that I lived in Pennsylvania for a while, and towns that my ancestors came from. I have like all kinds of different numbers mixed up, you know, anniversary dates, birth dates, things like that. It's just, it's really fun. And I hope you like this background as much as I do. And it's the background that we are using for the sew along quilt. But I have a feeling I'm going to be using this for a lot of things. So that's the background. And so with each, let me just show you this first before I talk about the prints. With each collection, I like to do what I call a specialty print. And I just talked to you about that in the stitch one and showed you that one. This is the specialty print. Let's see, let's get that right side up. This is the specialty print that I did for flea market. And it just looks like vintage kitchen wallpaper or curtains like my grandma had. And so that's what I'm going to be doing with this specialty print is curtains and for my kitchen. And I just love it. I'm going to be doing pillowcases, you know, backs of pillows, table runners, things like that out of it. I really love how that turned out. Okay, so let's get into these prints. So I've gotten this one so far in the neutrals, and the other two prints that are neutrals look like this. And this is raisin ground and this is pebble. And all of these prints that I did, you know, I wanted to be reminiscent of a flea market and vintage fabrics and things you may collect from a flea market as far as vintage sheets, fabrics, different things, and may put together for something. And so that was kind of my inspiration for this collection. So here are the pinks and reds that I have so far. Oh, this fabric feels so yummy. And then here's some prints that I'm still waiting for. should be showing up next week sometime. There's that one. There's this very light one with the little flowers. There's this one that I called Feather. And there's this one in the Riley Red. So I think those will be a really nice addition to the pinks and reds in this collection. And then here I have the teals. So I think they've sent me all the teals. Let me look through my papers. Yeah, these are all the teals, so let me just show you one by one. I have both aquas and both teals in this collection. This one's got a jade background. So there's the teals. I've only received two greens so far. And I have three more. Coming, and all those greens we're going to be using for all the leaves. Now here's the aquas and the denims that I have so far. Look at this plaid. It's really fun. And let me just take these off, see how I did the plaid so that you can mix the denims and the aquas together. So here's another one of my polka dot prints. The plaid again. This one is like little hexies and little stars. It's my nod to English paper piecing. This is a new blue that I've added to my collection, and it's called Soldier. And I love how it goes with the denim as well. And here's this little print in Cottage. This is called Basket Weave. And then here's that rose floral in the blues. And I actually have a few more blues that are coming. So there's this print in a denim. This one, this little daisy in the Cottage color. This little one with the daisies in there. And this little applique piece. So those are the blues that are coming. And then I've got most of the oranges. I have four oranges in this collection. And then here's the one that I have yet to receive in the autumn color. So now I think, they've sent all of the yellows. So it's a beautiful golden yellow. I love just a little bit of yellow in my collections. This one I have several in different shades of yellows, from dark to medium to light. This is butterscotch. So I have like honey and beehive and daisy. So those are all the actual pre-yardage that I have, as well as I have all three wide backs. Okay, so here's one of them. So remember this rose print that I did, I just showed you. What I did for the wide backs is I made the rose print bigger and then put them all on a cloud ground. And I thought they would be beautiful for backings or for some reason, these look like sheets. I need to make sheets for my bed out of these. But this is the red and the pink. This is the blues. Sorry, they're just all big bundles and kind of wrinkly. I just barely got them. And then the neutrals. So those are the 108 inch wide, 106, 108 wide backgrounds. Oh, wow, they're really heavy. Okay, let me grab the storyboard and see what I Okay, so we've gone through those fabrics. When we turn to this page, this is my cheater, but I don't have anything to show you of that yet other than what's on the storyboard. So this is the actual scale of the cheater cloth, and this is a picture that you can see of all of the colors and prints that are in there. Just bring that closer so you can see it. So on that page we have the cheater. Again, I'll be making a quilt for my bed with that and tying it with my chunky thread. And then the next page, I have two panels in this collection, and I don't have anything to show you yet from those, but I'm excited about these panels. They are in two colorways, and these blocks right here, let me just bring them up a little bit closer. I do have a printout that's just a little bit bigger. That might help when I'm trying to explain. Let me grab these. Okay, so here's, you can see the difference better in these two colorways. So what they are, they're pre-printed applique blocks. So you simply can just take these blocks. These are, if I remember right, about 16 inches square, these large ones. And you simply can take them and grab another print from Flea Market, put it on the back, sew them together, and you have an instant pillow. And I really like that because I love to make beautiful applique pillows, but sometimes I like them for looks, and I don't like them to be laid on or, you know, in the family room. And so these, you can do that, put them in the family room, and they can be played with and pillow fights and all that stuff, and you don't have to worry about ruining all your beautiful applique work. Now these little pieces right here, I believe they're 6-inch blocks. So you can make miniature quilts, smaller quilts, do alternate blocks. You can make pin cushions out of them, project bags, just all these little blocks. There's a lot of possibilities. They're, you know, ready-made little cheater prints for you. And then I had a little bit left on the fabric here, the strip. And so I took some of these applique pieces out and put them there. And you could actually hand applique these or use Wonder Under and do some different projects, make flowers out of them for, you know, apron pockets, bags. Now, I don't like to waste any fabric when I'm designing, and I also had a little strip here, and you can't really see it, but on here is printed when you get the label is all of my ideas that you can do with these panels. So again, these will be here next month with Flea Market, and I'm pretty excited about those. Okay, what's next in the storyboard is the quilt, the invitation. This sew-along starts Monday, January 25th, so that's coming right up at the first of the year, and I always do a Be Prepared blog post the first Monday of the month of the sew-along. So the first Monday in January, go to my blog, which is beinmybonnetco.blogspot.com. Well, I will have a total and complete supply list and everything you need for this quilt, and just give you tips and hints, and you'll be able to download the sew-along guide then. So my sew-alongs are free. You just need to copy the sew-along guide, and you need to have the fabric kit and either Sew Simple Shapes or rulers. Now in this case, we're going to be using rulers. So I'm going to show you what I have for those, but first I want to show you, I have a binder for this now. With each collection of fabric, I'll be having a binder that comes out for the sew-along guide. So when you download your sew-along guide for Flea Market, this is the Flea Market binder, and you can put it right in here, and it will match your quilt, and then you can keep it in there for future reference or use this binder for anything in your sewing room. Also, we're using this is, let me take that plastic off. This is the coral large vintage trim, and we'll be using that right here inside the binding for the quilt. So I wanted to show you that. That's a fairly new color. Okay, I'm gonna close this up and show you what I've got on here and just kind of put this in here so you can maybe see it a little bit, hopefully. So I normally use Sew Simple Shapes, but I'm doing a different take on this quilt because I wanted to do Flea Market flowers, so I wanted to use Dresden's for the petals. So here's my pie ruler. So you can see there's all different kinds, sizes of Dresdens here. And so we use the same ruler to make all these different sizes. We just cut our wedges different heights. So that's the pie ruler. This has been out for quite a while. We've used it for other sew-alongs. And then we have circles inside the quilt. There'll be four sizes. And that is my circle ruler set that we've used in several sew-alongs, the same exact set that we used for Granny Chic, for the Granny's Garden sew-along. And this is what those circles look like. So now the Dresdens, we're not using the interfacing because we don't need to, because the raw edges are already turned under. And I'll show you a couple of blocks that I made in a minute so that you can see what I'm talking about. But those edges are already turned under, so we don't need any sew-in interfacing for that. The only thing that we will need the sew-in interfacing for are the circles, and we get those with the circle rulers. And then I have a new set called the seed rulers here in these two sizes. Let me set it here so you can see better. And they make the leaves like this. So here's the interfacing on the back, how we've turned, and they're all ready to applique. Now, I'll have this is always the step-by-step tutorials on my blog for this, but I just kind of wanted to show you those shapes. I'll also have it here on my YouTube channel, and so you can see exactly how I do them. Let me show you a couple of blocks that I did. Kind of mocked up because I didn't have all of the fabric yet. These are not exact ones that go in the quilt. These are just fun blocks that I can do with the circles and the leaves and the Dresdens. Let me put it sideways first so you can maybe see the whole thing. But here's one that I did and used both sizes of leaves. You can stack the circles, you can do all the same fabric, or you can use several fabrics. There's just a lot of possibilities. These are not appliqued yet. I just put them together last night. I was so excited to start working with this fabric, and they are all glue basted and ready to applique. Now this one is the same size Dresden that I did. This is not the largest Dresden that we're doing in the quilt. This is kind of one of the medium-sized one, and I've only stacked two circles, and I've used both the same size leaves with the two greens that I had been sent. So I just wanted to mock those up and show those to you to kind of give you an idea of what this looks like. But this is what I meant by the Dresdens, how we sew them. They're already, the raw edges are turned under. So this is just straight fabric that goes onto the background. And then these have the sewing interfacing. So that's what those are. And I also wanted to show you, these will be coming. This is another mug that I have for the flea market. And I believe these are actually here now. These are two of the charms. I always have to do charms so that you can put them on the zipper pulls of project bags or keychains or whatever. And they're really fun. And that's just a few things that I actually have in my hands so that I could show you about flea market. If you're interested in doing any of my sew-alongs and you want to know where a fabric kit is, just contact your local quilt shop or look at quilt shops online and just search, you know, for the kit. Maybe you can search a flea market flowers kit, Lori Holt via my bonnet, and you'll find many shops that carry it. And look on Instagram. Follow me on Instagram, BLori1, and you can see what I'm doing there and get all the information about the sew-alongs. So I hope you have enjoyed today's video about things of my fabrics that I have coming soon. Cash, do you want to hand me that storyboard right there? So this is Flea Market. It's coming next month. And this is Stitch. That will be available next July 2021. We work about a year ahead of time, and I'm super excited about both of these collections. Thanks for joining me, and I'll chat with you later.